Welcome to day 38 of our 40 days of personal revival. And there's things in scripture that are just said over and over and over again. There's things that I preach over and over and over again. There's things that God tells us over and over and over again. Let me give you an example. Sometimes when I'm really stuck in message prep and I have several ideas about what I'd like to talk, and I start to get a little, I don't want to say anxious, but confused. Time is counting down. I want to do good sermon prep. I'm not sure what direction to go in. I can get out of the spirit and kind of into my head, kind of intellectually trying to figure out what it is I'm supposed to do. And I'll finally get smart and go before the Lord in the midst of my anxiety, in the midst of my confusion. I'll say, Lord, what do you want me to tell these people? And God will often tell me, tell them that I love them. That's the message he tells me to send. And instantly, I'm taken out of my confusion, I'm taken out of my agenda, and I'm put back onto God's agenda. He doesn't want me to give more information, he wants me to convey his spirit, right? And so, in scripture, we see time and time and time again, God brings us back to the essentials. And we see in this chapter, Paul is before Agrippa, and Agrippa thinks that he's putting Paul on trial. But hear me, anytime there's a believer and a non-believer, it's the heart of the non-believer that's on trial. Amen? And so he's talking to Agrippa, and Paul starts preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ again. There's a trial. People think they're going to question one of the apostles or even Christ himself, and all they get is the gospel. And in the midst of this, Agrippa says to Paul in verse 28, Agrippa replied to Paul, in a short time, you will persuade me to become a Christian. Now, what's funny is Agrippa thought that that was like some big deal or some supernatural thing that Paul had never heard of before. Agrippa had no idea. Paul's like, no, this gospel is the power of God for salvation. That's why I am sharing it. So often we get stuck thinking that our words are so important and our thoughts are so important and that what we come up with is just so vital to God's plan. But really, it's the gospel of Jesus Christ that is the power of salvation. Time and time and time again, the scriptures point us back to Jesus and what he did and what he's accomplished, and his plans are really at the center of everything God is doing. Today, recalibrate your thoughts. Recalibrate your plans. Recalibrate your strategies. And make sure Jesus Christ and his purposes are at the center. Amen? God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow.